In this illustration, we'll discuss about a rotating cylinder inside a hollow cylinder. We are given that a solid cylinder of radius R1, which is 150 mm, rotates concentrically inside a fixed hollow cylinder of inner radius R2. And both cylinders are having a length 300 mm. And here, we are required to determine the viscosity of liquid which fills the space between cylinders if a torque of 0.98 Nm is required to maintain the angular speed of 60 rotations per minute. Now, in this situation, we can see the angular speed which is maintained here is omega, which we write 60 rotation per minute, that is 1 revolution per second. So this is 2 pi multiplied by 1, which is 2 pi radian per second is the angular speed. And to maintain it, we need to apply the torque equal to the torque of viscous forces on it. So in this situation here, we can see the layer of liquid which is in contact with the outer cylinder will be at rest, and the layer of liquid which is in contact with the rotating cylinder will be having a speed equals to R1 omega. So here we can write the speed of liquid layer in contact with inner cylinder is, this will be R1 omega. So we can easily calculate the velocity gradient of a liquid in the annular region is, this velocity gradient dv by dx we can write as v divided by the separation, that is R2 minus R1. So this R1 omega divided by R2 minus R1 is the velocity gradient, and from this we can calculate the viscous force which is acting in tangential direction, because the cylinder is spinning and the viscous force is opposite to the motion on a cylinder, as this can be given as this viscous force is eta a dv by dx. So we can substitute the values eta, and the area in contact is 2 pi r1 l multiplied by this r1 omega by r2 minus r1. So as we have got the viscous force, due to this viscous force, we can calculate the torque by multiplying with the radius. So here we can write the external torque required to maintain omega should be equals to torque of viscous forces. This implies here we can write the external torque is due to the opposite viscous force torque, and that will be equals to viscous force multiplied by R1. If we substitute the value here, this will be 2 pi L eta multiplied by, here you can see this 2 pi L eta, this becomes omega R1 cube divided by this R2 minus R1. So this is the force of viscosity, and this multiplied by R1 gives us the viscous torque. So in this situation here, we can substitute the value of omega, which is 2 pi radian per second. So this will further give us 4 pi square eta l r1 cube divided by r2 minus r1. So this is the external torque required, and we are given that the required torque is 0.98 newton meter. So if we equate this value to 0.98, simplifying this expression, we'll get the value of coefficient of viscosity. So this implies here the value of eta we are getting is the 0.98 multiplied by here R2 minus R1 is 5 mm. So this multiplied with 5 into 10 to power minus 3 divided by 4 pi square. Here pi square we can take as 10 multiplied by L. The length of cylinder is given as 300 mm, which is 30 centimeter. We can consider it to be 0.3, and R1 cube we need to take, that is 5 into 10 to power minus 3 mm is the radius. So we can consider here R1 cube to be equals to 0.15 mm. So this multiplied by 10 to power minus 3, because it's 150 mm, so I can cancel it, and we can take the cube of 0.15 as this 15 centimeter. Now if we simplify this expression, this gives us a result 0.121 partially. That is the result of this problem.